أنشدت بسم الله ثم الحمد له فالله أهل الحمد إن الحمد له يا ربي أنت كلما رزقتني رأيت خيرا سابغا لحد له بك الرجاء وحبكم ربي سرى في القلب ثم زانه فجمله أنت الذي سترت ما يعيبني وجدت لي.
As for our khatira today, I realized that there was a very important hadith that I was delaying and delaying to say to you, and inshallah I really need to say it today before we move on, because this hadith is perhaps the most important hadith about Surat Al-Fatiha, and we will come back to it over and over again. So I will say it for the first time today, but you must memorize it and I will refer to it over and over again. And it is really the most detailed hadith about Surat Al-Fatiha, and it is narrated in the Sahih of Imam Muslim, the Sunan of Abu Dawud, the Jami' of Tirmidhi, the Mustad of Imam Ahmad, all of these books mention it. Abu Huraira said that the Prophet ﷺ said that Allah said. So we now have a hadith Qudsi. Abu Huraira, he's the most famous narrator of hadith, saying, I heard the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ say that Allah has said. And this is the highest and the most noble level of hadith. Hadith Qudsi means a sacred hadith, a noble hadith. And it is called Qudsi because this is second only to the Qur'an. The Qur'an is the speech of Allah. Hadith Qudsi is also speech of Allah, but it's not in the Qur'an. Hadith Qudsi is also speech of Allah, but it is not in the Qur'an. It is preserved in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. So the most sacred of all hadith is Hadith Qudsi. And it occupies a level, if it is authentic, it occupies a level underneath that of the Qur'an. So what did our Prophet ﷺ say? That Allah has said, قَصَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي نِصْفَيْنِ I have divided the salah between myself and between my servant in two equal halves. وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ And my servant shall get what he asks in his half. So the hadith begins, I have divided the salah between myself and my servant in two equal halves. And my servant shall get his half, i.e. So I will get my half, yes, but the servant will get his half as well. Then what did the Prophet ﷺ say that Allah said? Then Allah says, when the servant says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. And the hadith goes ayah by ayah. So pause here. Our Lord said, I have divided the salah between my servant and myself. And then he goes on to talk about Surat Al-Fatiha only. It is as if Surat Al-Fatiha is the essence of Salah. And that's why it is called the Salah. I have divided the Salah between myself and my servant. Then the hadith only mentions Fatiha. So Fatiha has been called Salah. And if you go back to the very first or the second lecture I gave, I said one of the names of the Fatiha that some of the Sahaba said is Suratul Salah. They call this the Surah of Salah. Why? Because of this hadith. That our Lord has called this surah, he has said it is the salah. Why? Because the Fatiha embodies everything about our religion. It summarizes the relationship between Allah and us. And that is really what our religion is all about. And what is the purpose of the salah? The purpose of the salah is to remind ourselves of the purpose of life. And that is why Fatiha is called the salah. So what did our Lord say? I have divided the salah between my servant and myself in two equal halves. Now pause here, how can there be two equal halves when there's seven ayats? We will see. Three here, and one in the middle. Three for Allah, and three for the servant, and one that is the connection between the two. And that's the beauty of the Fatiha. Three verses are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first three. The last three, dua for the servant. And the middle ayah is the linkage between Allah and the servant, that is Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. And we'll come to this, that's the whole purpose of our entire tafsir. So what does the hadith say? Allah says, one my servant says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. I say, Hamidani Rabbi, Hamidani Abdi, excuse me. My servant has praised me. So Allah is happy. Allah is happy that my servant has praised me. When my servant says, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, then Allah says, Athna Alayya Abdi. And the difference between hamd and thana is very technical, and thana is a type of hamd that is repeated. So thana is also a type of praise, but generally speaking, thana is a hamd that is repeated. And if you look at it, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, it has been repeated, is it not? Because how do you begin the Fatiha? Bismillah, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Then you say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Then you say again, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. So it is very appropriate to say, Athna Alayya Abdi. That my servant has repeated his praise of me. Athna Alayya Abdi. Then the servant says, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawm Al-Din. And Allah says, Majjadani Abdi. My servant has glorified me. Majjada means tamjid, of Allah's names is al-majid. We translate al-majid as the glorious. So tamjid of Allah means to exalt the status of Allah. And when you say maliki yawm al-din, you are exalting the status of Allah. So Allah says, my servant has given me exaltation. Majjadani abdi. Then the servant says, Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. So Allah says, this is between me and my servant. This ayah is the link between me and my servant. هَذَا بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي. So this is the linkage now. You alone do we worship, O Allah. And you alone are the one whose help that we seek. And by the way, even in this, there are two statements. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ and then إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. And إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ relates to the first three ayats. We worship you, O Allah. Because you are Allah, the Rabbul Alameen, the Rahman, the Rahim, the Maliki Yawm al-Din. So, Iyaka Na'bud. Then the next, the half surah is the wow. Iyaka Na'bud, then the half surah is wow. Wa Iyaka Nasta'een. You alone are the one whose help we ask. And then the rest of the surah is a help from Allah. Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. Sirat al-Ladina Amta alayhim. Ghayr al-Maghdubi alayhim wal ad-dallin. So that wow of Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'een is quite literally dividing the surah in two. The first half deals with Allah and glorifying Allah. And the second half deals with what we want from Allah. Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. We'll come to that when we come to it. And so quite literally, the surah is divided neatly in half. The first three ayat praising Allah. Then based on that praise, what do we do? Iyaka na'bud. We are worshipping you, O Allah, because you are Allah, and you are Rabbul Alameen, and you are Rahman, and you are Rahim, and you are the Malik of Yawm al-Din. So we are worshipping you. But then what do we want from you, O Allah? Iyaka na'bud wa iyaka nasta'een. We need your help, O Allah. After worshipping you, we need your help to worship you. So what do we need from you? اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ نَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ. So Allah says, when the servant says, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, Allah says, this is between me and my servant. This is establishing the relationship, the linkage between me and my servant. And now that the linkage has been established, وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ, my servant shall get anything he wants. What he will ask, he will get. So Allah Azza wa Jal is pleased when the servant praises him. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, my servant has hamidani. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, my servant has athna alayya. Maliki Yawm al-Din, my servant has majjadani. So Allah is happy that my servant is worshipping, is praising, is glorifying. Then the servant says, Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Allah says, now I have a relationship. Hadha bayni wa bayna abdi. This is now the relationship between me and my servant. Now let him ask as he please, he shall get it. وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ. And then the servant says, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Guide us to the straight path. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. The path of those whom you have shown your blessings. غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ. Not the path of those who have been shown anger. وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ. Nor the ones who are astray. Then Allah says, هَذَا لِعَبْدِي. This is what my servant will get. Because he asked me, after praising me, after glorifying me, after giving my hamd and thana and majd, now he will get whatever he wants. And so the servant asks, and then when he asks, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هَذَا لِعَبْدِي وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ. This is for my servant, and my servant shall get anything that he asks for. This beautiful hadith of Abu Huraira, narrated in Sahih Muslim and other books, I need you to memorize it, because we're going to come back to it over and over again. And inshaAllah ta'ala, because of the weather, we're going to cut it a little bit short inshaAllah, and we will continue this tomorrow bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لا يزال الخير حيا لا يزال إن في الدنيا سلاما وظلال أخبر الأيام أنها في وصال قم بنا وانظر لآيات الجمال قم بنا وانظر لآيات الجمال.